A central tenet of many economic theories is that people care about inequality. But an individual's social position can be defined relative to numerous reference groups. Is inequality across neighbors viewed differently from inequality across coworkers? Do people accurately perceive their social status in these different groups? And are some forms of inequality seen as more unfair than others? This paper explores these questions using a unique dataset from Denmark. Assisted by Statistics Denmark, the authors surveyed nearly 10,000 individuals on their knowledge of the income distribution across 5 reference groups. For each respondent, these were defined based on their birth cohort, gender, municipality, level of education, and sector of work. For each group, respondents were asked to guess the income level of those at the 50th and 95th percentiles of the income distribution, and to guess their own position in the distribution. They were also asked whether they think income differences within each group are fair or unfair, and whether they can be attributed to effort or luck. Crucially, these survey responses were then linked to detailed administrative data on each individual's full income history, life events, and true position in the income distributions of each group. This allows the authors to assess the accuracy of people's perceptions of their social position, and to explore whether changes in these positions over time affect their views on the fairness of inequality. To start, they find that on average, people have a fairly accurate perception of overall income levels. Perceptions of P50 are closely aligned to their actual levels, indicating that individuals are well aware of core income differences across different groups of people. But there are also systematic misperceptions. In particular, there is a recurrent pattern of center bias. People generally think they are closer to the center of the income distribution than they actually are. Here, we see respondents' perceived position in their cohort relative to their actual position. Those who are ranked lower tend to think they are ranked higher, while those who are ranked higher tend to think they are ranked lower. This phenomenon is not specific to the cohort income distribution. Across all reference groups, there is a clear pattern of center bias. To help explain this, note that survey respondents did not misperceive their own income. Reported income closely matches actual income from the administrative data. Rather, center bias arises because those with higher incomes tend to overestimate other people's incomes, while those with lower incomes tend to underestimate other people's incomes. As seen here, there is an increasing relationship between the perceived cohort P50 and P95 income levels and the respondents' own position in the distribution. Those at the very top overestimate P95 by nearly 50%. Now, center bias is a consistent pattern, but misperceptions are also larger in some reference groups than in others. While perceptions of P50 are reasonably accurate across all groups, respondents systematically underestimate the P95 income levels in their education and sector groups. These are also the groups where misperceptions of own position are largest amongst those lower in the distribution. Thus, more so than in other groups, people misperceive the extent of inequality among people with their same level of education and working in the same sector. What about views on the fairness of inequality? These figures plot respondents' survey responses against their perceived position within each group. Higher values correspond to the view that inequality is more unfair, and that income differences are due to effort rather than luck. Two patterns stand out. First, social positions are correlated with views on fairness. Those who think they are ranked higher in a given group believe that inequality in that group is less unfair, and that income differences are the result of effort rather than luck. Second, at all positions in the distribution, respondents believe that inequality within education and sector groups is more unfair than inequality within cohort, gender, or municipality. One potential reason is that education and type of work are seen as key determinants of income. Yet, as seen before, these are also the reference groups in which misperceptions of inequality are largest. As such, people are less informed about inequality and social position in the precise context where it matters most to them. Finally, what factors shape people's views on fairness? This figure plots respondents' current views against their cohort position measured at different points in time. Fairness views are more strongly related to current than past social position. In fact, life events that shift a person's social position also shift their fairness views. Negative shocks such as unemployment or disability lead individuals to perceive inequality as more unfair, while positive shocks such as promotions at work lead them to view it as less unfair. To directly test the impact of changes in perceived position, the authors also randomly informed half of the sample of their true social position before soliciting their views on fairness. They find that individuals who overestimated their social position start viewing inequality as more unfair once they are informed of their actual lower position. In conclusion, this paper sheds light on perceptions of inequality across different reference groups. People care about their social position, but these findings suggest that many factors affect their knowledge of and attitude towards inequality in different contexts. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on perceptions of inequality, the impact of inequality on well-being, and determinants of people's views on inequality.